On BBC Two shortly, comedy with the further adventures of Lucky Jim. In 25 minutes on One, the Monday film stars Charles Bronson as Mr. Majestic. Now the 9 o'clock news with John Humphreys.
The region was devastated by floods last month, and today the Pope announced that the Vatican would be sending money for reconstruction. Floods in France too, and at least 11 people have died. Storms have been battering southern and western parts of the country for the past 2 days. Thousands of people were forced to leave their homes on the Mediterranean coast near Montpellier. Most of the victims were killed by uprooted trees or roofs and chimneys brought down by the high winds. At least 27 prisoners have died in a fire at the Harrison County Jail at Biloxi in Mississippi. It's believed it was started deliberately by an inmate who set his mattress alight. Most victims died from the effects of smoke. 50 others were injured. The Northern Ireland Secretary is to visit the United States next week to urge Americans to stop the flow of money and arms to the IRA. Mr. Pryor's initiative follows the controversial acquittal in New York of 5 men accused of gun running. Today, a judge postponed the trial of 4 more men accused of buying missiles and guns for terrorists in Northern Ireland. Mr. Pryor has said he's disappointed by the not guilty verdicts returned last week. From New York, Martin Bell reports.
The 5 men were tried at the Brooklyn Federal Courthouse and acquitted on what's called the CIA defense, that they did what they did with the knowledge and consent of the CIA. The trial was to have begun today of 4 other men accused of trying to ship surface-to-air missiles to the IRA, and the same defense would have been used. But the judge adjourned the trial for 3 months on the ground of what he called the emotional reaction to the earlier acquittal. Emotional? It certainly was. There was a weekend of partying in the Irish community, a police pipe band, and some of the jurors took part. And the quality of justice at this Brooklyn courthouse does seem to have given the IRA and its well-wishers something to celebrate.
The first time Irishmen have been acquitted of gun running, and it's also the first time they've said, well, yeah, we did it, and we're proud of it.
And there was a police pipe band there?
There was a pipe band. I didn't get what they were. I believe there was the Emerald Society.
And 2 of the jurors?
At least 2, yes.
What do you think of that as a man of law?
Well, after it's over, they go back into the populace. Doing it before is a crime. Doing it afterwards, I believe, is a courtesy.
And Irish Northern Aid, from its fundraising office above a supermarket at the tip of Manhattan, reports that its campaign is going better than at any time since the hunger strike.
We are now getting back up. I believe we're going to surpass that through the campaign. It's still too early to tell, but every event we've run since then, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, it just astounded us. It was totally beyond our expectations.
To the old campaign, there's now a new one, encouraged by the 5 acquittals and the celebrations that followed. It's a campaign through juries, judges, and police to influence the course of justice.
John DeLorean has appeared in a Los Angeles court charged with drug trafficking. He entered a plea of not guilty, and he's already saying that he will be found innocent. Simon Dring was in court to watch the proceedings.
Released from prison on bail last week, DeLorean's arrival at the court was treated as a major press and television event. Standing with his wife, Christina, who has had her hair cut extremely short since his arrest, DeLorean refused to make any statement. But one of his lawyers emphasized that they believed very strongly in his innocence and said they would prove it.
You all know, of course, that this case has had a great deal of publicity. I think everybody who reads that should bear in mind that almost all of the publicity is coming from the government and through agents closely associated with the government. You must therefore realize that much of it is half-truths, some of it is downright false.
DeLorean is expected to stay on in Los Angeles for several more days to confer further with his lawyers before returning to his home in New York. The conditions of his bail are such that his movements are severely restricted, and he's required to report to a parole officer 2x a week.
To add to his problems, John DeLorean could now face further criminal charges. It's believed that what started as a routine scrutiny of his finances by the Internal Revenue Service may now be expanded into a wider investigation to probe the possibility of tax fraud and illegal stock transfers, both linked with his handling of the affairs of the DeLorean Motor Company in Belfast in the United States.
Sorry about the breakup in some of the pictures there. Talks have been going on all day in an attempt to solve the health workers' dispute, which has now lasted for 7 months. Members of the TUC